Today we're going to do a full review on this Wi-Fi color forecast wireless weather station from Crosse Technology. It comes complete with an outdoor temperature and humidity sensor and a phone app to keep you updated on changes at home. Now, I did receive this as a free review product from Crosse Technology. A couple years back, I did a review of one of their wireless weather stations, which we still use today. It's been awesome. Haven't had any problems with it, but I haven't done a review like this in a while. I do know there are some other weather buffs out there just like myself. I've spoke to you through email, online, and whether you're making your weather station with Arduino or connecting it to Raspberry Pi, or whether you're purchasing retail, I believe Crosse Technology makes some of the best wireless weather stations out there, and today we're going to take a look at this and see what we think. Well, here's the box that it came in. It's a little bit smaller, it appears, than the other one that I did a review on, but like I said, it does have the phone app, the outdoor monitor, and then the indoor monitor that gives you all the information. Let's turn it over to the back. Something's caught my eye here. Under the home conditions, you can do customizable alerts, and for the enhanced forecast, it says here extended forecast high and low temperature data. That'll be interesting to take a look at. Let's open it up and take a look at it. Once you open it up, you got the wall adapter here, which plugs right into the back of your monitor. You got your monitor here. You've got your outdoor sensor, and you've got two manuals, one in French and then one in English. So we'll read the English one today. You want to plug it in and you want to pull the plastic tab out that was right here. And the first thing we're going to do after we've opened it, we're going to put two fresh AA batteries in our sensor. Just like that. And we'll snap the cover back on. And once you plug this in, you're going to have to wait, I don't know, I waited 3 or 4 minutes for the data to pop up on the screen here. You may have to wait up to 10 minutes. So be patient with that. But what we're going to do next is go download the Crosse View app on our cell phone so that we can sync that with the weather station here. So I'm using an Android, so I'm going to go into the Play Store. I'm going to go up here and search Crosse View. And there it is at the top. And I want to install it. Now we're going to open the app. And we'll provide an email and a password to log in. Or you can also create your account. So once you've downloaded the app, and you probably will create a new one just like I did, you enter your name, your email address, you verify your email address, and then enter in a password and you verify that as well. And then account is created. Would you like to continue to set it up? Allow Crosse View to take pictures and record video? Okay. Now at this point we want to locate the barcode on the device and scan that barcode, or you can manually enter it. We're going to scan it. We're going to flip over our sensor here. There's a barcode on the back and we're going to scan that. Right here there should be a picture of my sensor, but there's not. But I'm going to go ahead and click yes. Then we're going to name our device. We'll name it Weather Station. Location name, I don't know, I just put outside for now. We can change that later if we want. And hit continue. Now that we've added our sensor, we want to add our weather station. So we get on here and click on the plus sign. There's a barcode on the back of our weather station, and that is what we're going to scan just like we did for the sensor. See how there's a picture of my monitor here? That should have happened for the sensor, but it didn't, and that really messed me up in the setup. So after scanning the barcode on the back of our weather station, I named it Weather Station. Location name inside, you can change that any time. And you can come down here to country, United States. You can enter a postal code or city. I will enter mine. And then you can opt out, and then we'll hit continue. You're going to enter your password for your Wi-Fi. Now press the Wi-Fi button on the back of your device. So we will turn this around here, press that Wi-Fi button right there. And this will put your device in Wi-Fi configuration mode. I did this. Next. Is Wi-Fi symbol flashing? Yes, it is. This wasn't the easiest thing to set up, so basically what you're going to have to do is go back and redo it all again if you don't get it the first time, and that will involve scanning the barcode on the back right there and then entering your SSID and your password to your Wi-Fi. You need them both, and then once you do that, you will see that the Wi-Fi will stop blinking. Honestly, it could have been my fault that I couldn't connect the first time, but the app does give pretty good suggestions on how to connect. And if you don't get it the first time, try it the second time. It'll keep cycling through, telling you to do different things. But basically, you need to enter your SSID and your Wi-Fi password for this to work. And if you don't get there, then just keep trying. Try to go back to that, but I can't redo everything that I did, unfortunately. So it did take a couple tries. I entered the wrong password the first time, but yeah, finally got it. And just cycling through the suggestions in the app, and finally got me there. And the last thing I did was actually enter the ID to my Wi-Fi and the password. And we're outside setting up our sensor. And if you remember, I did a separate video using this little cover here to go over your sensor to protect it from the weather and from direct sunlight. And it's been awesome. As you can see, it's still pretty clean, still intact. It does a great job. You want to put your sensor somewhere where it's not going to receive direct sunlight or rain. And this is the old sensor. It's still in excellent condition. 2.5 years old. It's been sitting in this little plastic shield here the whole time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the new sensor. I'm going to put it in there. It barely fits, but it does fit. And I just swap the Velcro on the back. There's Velcro that helps hold it in place on this little platform, and I just swapped it onto the new one. So all you got to do is place it here on the platform. Then you put the cover on it, and it'll twist and lock at the base. Now it's time to go back to the bracket on the fence and then slide this in place to keep it locked in. Sorry about the camera angle here. I'm using one arm, so I wasn't really looking at the camera. But yeah, you just slide it down and leave it until next year and you change your battery. Pretty sturdy. And I'll link the review that I did using this cover. I'll link it in the description if you want to go check that one out. I wasn't sure how much I'd like this app, but it is easy to use and it's very convenient to have. And when you log into the app, this is your background picture. If you want, you can change that by tapping that camera picture right there. You can either take your own photo, which you'll have to give access to the app to do that, permission, and we're not going to do that right now. Or you can add your own photo. Up here, if you tap this little cloud looking thing, this is for your notifications. I don't have any set up at the moment. If you tap this other icon over here, it looks like an S, it'll just move the temperature from the top of the to the bottom. And I like to keep it down here anyway at the bottom. So if we scroll down, right now it's set on weather station inside. So if we scroll down, it's 71 degrees, 55% humidity inside. And this shows you the highs and the lows, I guess. And a graph right here as well. And if we go up here and select this, we can select the outside weather sensor. Now outside it's 83 degrees, 58% humidity. And down here, it'll give you the highs and the lows. Now, I just took it outside, so you do see a little spike right here after 4 p.m. That is when I took it outside. And I put it in its little case. And so that's that. So if we click up here again, we can go to locations. Now, this is locations. And here, I set up a sensor for the inside, which is my weather station, and then the one outside, which is the sensor. Now, if you accidentally set up one that you don't have, or you just want to get rid of one, you can tap this little minus sign up here, and you can get rid of the location. It's not going to let me delete this one because I actually have something connected to it, I guess. And it shouldn't let me delete that one either. Yeah, I'd have to edit devices. You can add devices to this by coming down here, clicking the plus, and add that. So let's go ahead and get rid of that one. Yes, I want to delete that. All right. And we'll go up here and select our little menu again. Click on devices. If you get another device, you can add it here. And you'll have to scan the barcode like we did previously. But we're not going to do that. So anyway, that's where you would add your extra devices. I don't know what that button does. Oh, you can share. So you can share your data. All right, let's go back. Okay, and then open up our menu again. And down here we've got alerts. And I don't have alerts, but I can add one. And I can add an inside alert, maybe if it gets too hot inside. But let's add an outside alert, a temperature alert. So if the temperature goes above, I don't know, 118 seems pretty extreme. Let's say 106, I'll get an alert. If it goes below minus 20, let's say below zero, I get an alert. And if the heat index, and you can reset those, and the heat index, you can set that as well. But apparently you can't set them at the same time. So maybe you can just call this one heat index. Hey index. How about heat index? All right. And then save. So we just saved the heat index alert. Now you can go back and you can do your temperature, whatever you want it to be. There we go. Below 9, over 124. Show notification settings once hourly. All right, so you can set hourly or daily. And then you can get push notifications and email. Should hit save. Oh, well, let's name this one. Temperature, save. All right, so now I have two alerts, but I don't have any alerts yet, so you won't see them there. And you come down here, this is all of our account information, email, passwords, all that good stuff. Down here you can change the units. You can change it from Fahrenheit to Celsius. The wind is from miles per hour to meters per second or kilometers per hour. And the rain from inches to millimeters, and the distance from miles to kilometers. But I think at some point I would like to get a wind speed sensor. I think that would be pretty handy. And then down here you can just connect to the Wi-Fi there, and there's a little help area right here, and you can share the temperatures on your social media. So that's a little bit about this app. The app is convenient, very easy to use. I think you'll like the app. Now we can see how to navigate the settings menu, and you can do that by hitting set up here. And you're going to use the plus and minus to navigate the options for your answer. Once you've selected your answer, you hit set again. So let's hold set in. As you hold it in, it will say hello. And do I want to use English, Spanish, French, German? So let's do English. Beep on or off. I'll keep it off. Format is 12-hour format or 24-hour format. I like the 12-hour format. And then here you set your time. So let's just hit set since that's all correct. And set the year, 2022. Set the month here. And you can go back and forth with plus and minus. The date is the 14th. Set the month and the day. Okay, Fahrenheit or Celsius. It's Fahrenheit. Inches of mercury or hectopascal? Something like that. Let's do inches of mercury. Make it less confusing for me. And then once you're done, it will say thank you. Some of the other buttons on here, such as alerts. Hold the alerts button to enter the alert setting menu, and use the plus or minus buttons to activate and deactivate individual alerts, or press the alerts button to skip to the next alert option. Once activated, use the plus and minus buttons to adjust the alert value and press alerts button to confirm and move forward. If the alert sounds and you don't see a flashing alert icon, press the in out button on the top to view the other reading. Press any button on the monitor to make the alert beep stop. Alerts set on the station are separate from those created in the app. And next to the alerts, we have the temperature button. When you push this button, you can view the high and low record for the day, and you can cycle through different days by continually pressing the temperature button. I don't have an extra sensor, so I'm not going to mess a whole lot with extra sensors. So this button over here is in and out, and you can press that to view between indoor and outdoor. So that is my indoor conditions. You can see the picture of the house there, 73.4 or 73.9 degrees. Press it again. You can see the Christmas tree. You can see the pine tree there, and it's 82 degrees, 58% humidity. And that's what I'll keep it at. But you can switch between indoor and outdoor there, or you can have it scroll automatically back and forth. Next, we have forecast refresh. And we'll just press to refresh the forecast reading. So press that. And you just press this to update the extended outlook. This section in green here indicates our current conditions, and these three areas are the extended forecast. If you see this icon right here, that is the internet icon. This area right here is the high and low for today. And this 25% up here shows that there's a 25% chance of precipitation. And down here at the bottom are three forecast icons, and they forecast the weather within the next 12 hours. And if the weather has changed, you can press this forecast refresh to update your monitor. If you want to see an extended forecast beyond the forecast given on the monitor right here, you press this little button right here with the cloud and the sun. And when you press that, it'll give us 3 days beyond the 3-day forecast that it gives you on the main screen. For us, it's Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday main screen. By the way, there is a number of weather icons that you'll see, such as wind, clouds, rain, lightning. There's also snow, and they do change as the weather changes. Your display must be connected to the Wi-Fi to receive AccuWeather forecast data, and when connected, your station will display 6 additional forecast icons. This area right here is the relative pressure, and the relative pressure reading will come from your monitor's internal barometer. The green arrow above this value here represents the pressure tendency. There is an auto dim setting if you hold down this button right here. And it'll bring us to this screen, and we can hit the minus or the plus to turn it on and off. And then we hit this button right here to determine what time to set the auto dim. And you can adjust the time using the plus and minus buttons. We'll go ahead and set it for 11 p.m. And this is the time that the backlight would turn off. So press this button once again to set the auto dim stop time. It's set for 6 a.m. and this is the time that you'd want the backlight to come on. And you can adjust that time using plus or minus. And now we're going to determine what level of brightness we want for our backlight. Also, if you look right here, these bars are the sensor reception indicator. The transmission range is 400 feet or 121 meters in open air. Ours is about 60 feet away, just outside the house, and there's 3 walls in between here and the sensor. So far, this has been an excellent weather station. There was a little hiccup in the setup of the app, but the suggestions within the app got me on track pretty quick. I have no doubt that this is going to be another awesome weather station by Crosse, just like our previous Crosse weather station. If you want an update on its performance throughout the year, just leave a comment down below the video and I will reply.
Well, that's all I've got for you today. Thank you very much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to like it by clicking the thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and share it with somebody. I'll see you again very soon.